All right, so I am in Lagos, Nigeria. I'm at the airport waiting on my driver to pick me up. All right, Elsa, y'all see how insane this is right here, okay? The concept of yield does not exist. They don't wait, they just keep going. And you have to get in where you fit in. But the interesting thing I noticed is that for all of the chaos in the traffic, you don't see many accidents here, actually, which is quite interesting. This is a fuel queue because there's a scarcity of fuel right now. All these cars that you see along the side of the road, they're actually waiting on this one gas station, which you see us pulling up on right here. So you see all those cars just lined up, and this is going to pretty much be this way all day, right? Until they close, because this one is not open 24 hours, right? Okay. So we have to actually go around the fuel, but you all see that fuel queue. So believe it or not, that's interesting. There's a fuel shortage or there's fuel scarcity, but Nigeria is a oil-rich country. So that just tells you about how much the government has really failed the people here and why it's important for the country to have outside investment to not only help stimulate the economy more, but also provide hopefully more equitable distribution resources. But I just wanted to show y'all that we're actually turning into the estate where I have my Airbnb right now. And you can see I'm kind of just walking. So it's like a really decent neighborhood that I'm in with street lights and really nice estates. But yeah, I'm walking over here now. It's kind of temperature-wise, it's actually really comfortable. I would probably say it's about probably 75 at the most. I would say at the most, and it's not that humid. And I always say, people ask me what the weather's like here. The weather is similar to like Miami, right? It's kind of like that. You know, it can be humid at times, has a really nice breeze, because Lagos is a coastal city, so you'll get a nice breeze. This time of year is rain season, so it's gonna be a little cooler this time of year. But rain season ends, I think next month is August now, so I think rain season ends September, October. But yeah, so yeah, I'm walking. I will show you all kind of the outside and how lit this place gets after about, like, say 10 or 11. All right, so I'm leaving out of the estate now, and this particular state that I'm in, the estate that I'm in is secured entry, and you'll notice that those of you who come to visit, that is the norm for a nice estate. Now, in the United States, we would probably just call it a subdivision, but here they call them estates, and they could be pretty large. But you'll notice this security gate has an attendant there. After I think like 10 in this particular state, they close the gate. So you can't get in, quote unquote. I always get in, but that's because I tip. And if you watch my other video that I did with my friend, y'all remember we talked about tipping, the importance of tipping. Things, something simple as you being able to get into this. How you doing? Something just as simple as you being able to get into the estate after a certain time or not get in could just be as simple as you just tipping, right? And it's not that you won't be able to get in, it would just take you more time. It would become more of a hassle. But I'm crossing now, y'all. So I'm gonna shut this camera off, and then I'll show you when I get on the other side. This is the worst part sometimes about being a pedestrian in Nigeria is you need to get your ass across the street when you can because they do not stop at all. So I'm walking and I have to cross. Actually, the traffic's not too bad now. But yeah, so I'm about to cross. The building I'm going to is right across the street. So yeah, I'm kind of lucky, y'all, that traffic is not so bad. So y'all, this is the suya spot right here. Y'all see how they cooking? This is authentic Nigerian suya. Y'all see that? They have a line here. It's very delicious. They got all that goodness up there. So you can actually enter. I can enter actually in the front or on the side. Like, y'all will notice when I go in, they all know me. So I think I'm gonna make a grand entrance.
Baby, you're trying to divide my attention. I've been working on to sleep patiently for you to tell me your decision, my position. But I got a funny feeling like saying my heart is a redemption. Listen up, claim what you get before we get too late. Call you away, you know, you can get to 30 days. Pardon me, I love you, know I love you. Let me eat your word, baby, I have no fear. Even though you're better, you should let me know. You should let me know how you feel about me soon. I've had enough of you for me. I am dying for your loving. I am cause you stole my heart away. Cause I give up my love to you. Girl, I put your Bible on too. If you really, really want this love, baby, you should let me know. But that was only me letting you know I love you so. That is not even that the story should go. And it feels good. Love me somebody. Somebody loves you back. Somebody needs you back, needs you back. Listen, when you say, after all, that big say, done, you don't even show me you got it, you don't. You don't even make me feel like you're not bound. You don't even try to show me my position. It is only fair that you should let me know. You should let me know how you feel about me, so I am had enough for you, for me. I am mine for your love.
That's how it goes. You kind of lie to yourself.
You know, when you're... Look, I don't even know, y'all. I don't know if I was recording last time we were talking.
Yeah.
Was it recording last time?
Yeah, was
it? Did y'all... Was it?
Yeah.
Did it cut off?
Yeah, it cut off now.
Okay.
But it cut off that time.
Okay, come chocolate tea. You got to see some chocolate, y'all. Come on now.
Yeah. Look. The black of the bear, the white of the teeth, y'all. Come on now. Okay.
I do a lot of walking because it's a lot easier versus calling my driver. And coincidentally, that means that I know this area pretty well. I'm about to cross over. You all see the Prince Ibano supermarket. So I'm about to cross over, which will be a lot easier to do today since it's Sunday. So I'm crossing now. So I'm about to cross over. This is a somewhat of a task on like a Friday night or a Saturday night. My friend just crossed. I'm so busy making this video for y'all. I couldn't cross, but traffic is not too bad. So I'm just going to dart across the street. That any U.S. goods that you purchase in Nigeria are usually going to be significantly more expensive because of the import taxes and the duties and the fees they have to pay to get things over here. So like this, just to get an example, this is like $10. And we know that you can buy this for like probably what, $5, $6 in the U.S. Y'all see they have these chicken. Just give me like four. They have these like chicken pies, which is similar to like, they call them meat pies, but that's very similar to Jamaican meat pies, but they don't taste the same. They kind of more of a, have a different flavor to me.
Hello. Hey, thank you. Can I get a pack of the legs and a pack of the wings? That's gonna be it. I think that's good.
So $22,000 is about $15, everybody, just so you know. So I would say this is about average, I would say. Other section, there's some other items I need to get. Hope y'all are enjoying my shopping expedition here in Prince Ibano Supermarket in Lekki, in the Lekki neighborhood of Lagos, Nigeria. So we're about to go up here, get a phone charger. I'm going to have to ask him where that is. I don't know where a phone charger is. Y'all jamming to Whitney Houston. That's another thing. Excuse me, you work here? We're looking for an iPhone charger or a phone charger.
Okay.
I'm loving my love. Have a little machine here for you to check the price. Slow. They don't have those conveyor belts anywhere. I have not been to any store. Everything is just kind of put up there. And they ring it one by one. So the checkout process is going to take a little bit longer. Well, a lot longer, depending on how many people working and how long the line is. So
about to cook this chicken
on this relatively breezy, beautiful Sunday. So this is a great, phenomenal day to kind of be outside and just enjoying maybe a pool, nice pool, some nice music, however you get your enjoyment. All right, y'all.
Hey, that's right. Come on. Let's go.
Actually, walking back from the restaurant you just saw, I'm within the subdivision. So we walking back right now. This area is the area that I spend most of my time in. It's Leckett Phase 1. So we walking back. Had a phenomenal time. That was an amazing time. A lot of people in Nigeria ride bikes. So they ride bicycles. They ride motorcycles. It's a very popular form of travel here. But in this particular part of Lagos, you can just really walk to most, really, you can have a good time without having a car.
For you, it's so entertaining.
Yeah, it's very entertaining. Yeah.
So other people, they feel like it's a stress for them.
Exactly. Well, that's true.
Uh-huh.
Some people, so you're right. It depends on the person. For me, it's good. Now, if you
park your car,
but here's the thing, everybody that comes will have their own driver though. So I want to make sure everybody, when you come, you can go wherever you want to go. You'll have your own driver. But for me personally, I just don't want to call my driver every time I'm trying to go somewhere. It's just not convenient for me. And I had to pay. My driver's not free. Now, I'm paying for y'all's drivers. Y'all drivers are included in your travel package. But for me, I'd rather just be somewhere central. So, and I've been coming to this same area for years, so I'm very familiar with this particular area. A lot of the people know me. my friends in Nigeria are trying to tell me that they're training me on Nigerian ways, which is, Jared, stop going to the same places all the time. And I'm listening to my Igbo friend and his brother. And okay, I'm going to stop doing that. And I'm going to tell you, Nigeria, Lagos has many jewels if you just are willing to explore them. So what is this, you think? What is this? Hey?
It's having a lunch for
a hotel.
What is it?
My friend says it's a hotel. I don't think that's a hotel. That's not a hotel.
You haven't seen it from up. We left the premises. From there, it's still white to here.
So it's not completed?
It's not completed.
All right, y'all. So we walking. So look. So this is another one again. This is another example, everybody. Housing units, fully constructed, fully completed. And you see, this is the butlers in Nigeria. They have what's called BQ. When you do a real estate project, you allocate a space for what's called a butler's quarter. These are your gate people. These are the people that let folks in. So that little building right there, that's where they are. And so they let people in and out of these gates, okay? Now, this development that we're doing, we're not going to need. I need to speak to the architect. I don't think we're going to need that, actually, because we're not doing the full estate. We're only buying 5,000 square meters. So what we build will be pretty much like this. Y'all will see the design. It's going to take another like 3 weeks for the design to be completed. So I'll show y'all the design. But this is exactly what we'll be doing. So it's not going to be a situation where we're going to need any, like, it's not going to be any HOA fees or anything like that. It'll just be a simple driveway up to the unit itself, right? And that's pretty much it. Now, when we do a larger development, now this is a pretty large development because, see, this is this one section right here. This gate person aids entry for all of this right here. Okay, so there's multiple buildings and even going towards the back that you're not seeing. So this is a larger scale development, but we're not doing anything this big. But this is just to give you an idea of how the housing units are situated within Lagos, Nigeria, and how we're going to be building the high density development. And the high density development in Lagos, Nigeria looks like this. Okay, so you have buildings with, you know, 8, 12, 15 units in them, and you're building them like this and you're selling them individually. So we would probably look at them as like condominiums in the United States or townhomes in the United States. And then we're selling those off for, you know, anywhere from $200,000 on the low end to about $300,000, $350,000 on the high end. And again, most of these units are sold, pre-sold before the construction is completed. All right.
Freedom. With Jerry.